Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. In today's video, we're looking at Dropbox Paper timeline. We're giving you an overview of how it works and what it means for the future of Dropbox Paper. So stay tuned for today's video. So guys, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. If you're brand new to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button. It'd be great to have you here. So we're just describing briefly the Dropbox Paper timeline function. It is obviously directly challenging applications like Coda by adding an interactive function. And as you can imagine, Dropbox Paper is a collaborative workspace for designers and agencies and people who like to collaborate using the likes of Google Docs, but in a more design-focused fashion. We'll be using this function to organize future stuff. So it's really simple. I believe this is rolling out. So if you don't have it available yet, I'm sure it will be rolling out on all accounts very soon. So you can see that obviously you've got all of your media area and there is a section called timeline. Create timeline is available. If I click create timeline, this gorgeous full bleed comes across the page and is interactive. So what it simply does is allows you as a team, for example, let's say you're working on a project, to plot ahead using this application. So as you can see, it's showing November. I can actually set milestones for the team if I wanted to create clear milestones. So for example, let's say at the end of the month, and the scrolling is really simple, I wanted to create a milestone of launch new PDF, and that's a set milestone there. That's a good way to be able to indicate to the team something's coming up. Now I can change the view. So for example, if I wanted to see that full month, and get rid of the previous one I created there, I can see, okay guys, we're on the 8th, but the 30th is the launch month of that. Now I can click into any of these dates and actually drag across. So for example, over the weekend, let's say we're doing a workshop on how to create the best PDFs. And as you can see, you can click in, you can add a description, you can change the color palette too. So if you wanted to be a bit detailed or even assign it to a person in your team, you can easily do so too. Now you can tick off this item if you complete it and you can add as many more as you like. So this application is really simple for that basis. So for example, if I wanted to add a few more, so for example, design PDF and give that a bit of a classier indication of an orange, then I can do so. And if I want to just assign it to myself automatically, I can do. And let's say I wanted to finalize with publisher PDF. And again, add a bit more detail there. So what I can do is obviously have a clear outline for the team on what's coming up. If I wanted to, I could go to quarter view as well as see the whole year ahead. So if you and your team are looking to manage the entire year ahead, that's something that you can do. Anyway, at the moment, obviously you can only check off, assign and add notes, but as you can imagine, they're probably gonna evolve this. Challenging interactive features like the likes of Airtable and Monday.com, but again, condensed into a document experience. So I see this as a competitive strategy against Coda, but let's see how it rolls out. Anyway, this should be rolling out to you. So do check it out. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Have you been using it already? It'd be great to hear. Anyway, guys, if you haven't checked out Dropbox Paper versus Coda feature, do check it out below. If you want to check out all the Skillshare classes we're launching, feel free to join and enjoy all of those below. Anyway, guys, huge thanks for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.